I need to do the same. The live stream appears to be up and running, I am sure.
Did I speak to your live? I don't have my bottle opener.
Well, what did you do with it?
I passed it to you last week. Oh, here it is.
Uh-huh.
It was hiding in the fleece.
Claiming I took your bottle opener when I most certainly didn't.
That's right. Last week you twisted off the cap.
Right, because it's a twist off. I have the bottle opener. Just getting sorted out. Let's see here, hopefully. Actually, I'm gonna try and see if I can arrange this a little better. Okay, so. And that hopefully gave it enough time for it to
actually start cleaning for at least 10 seconds.
Yeah. That looks like the shirt I'm wearing. Four people are already on. Okay. Caitlin and Adela. Your sister's on. Yeah, happy hump day or happy third Monday of the week. Depends on where you're sitting. Okay. All right. So, this comment is for Caitlin. So, I listened to Helplessly Hoping. We'll probably do that in the next, maybe do it next week or the week or two. But I went back and started listening to some Crosby, Stills, and Nash and realized that there was a wealth of songs by those guys that we hadn't done. So, and while Sweet Judy Blue Eyes may be stretching it, the Stretch My Skills song that I'd like to learn is their version, their song, Guinevere. I'm just blown away by David Crosby's guitar playing in that song. So, but we think we'll be having more Crosby, Stills, and Nash in the coming weeks, because at this point now we've at least figured we've got another 20 or more shows.
And we've done at least like one song by everybody, so we have to start reusing groups.
Although we were delving into, I watch movies on the treadmill, and I was watching Any Which Way You Can, the Clint Eastwood movie where he bare knuckles fights Jack Wilson. Pretty great movie, but the soundtrack in it's really great, and there's a bunch of great songs by Glenn Campbell. So I picked up Best of Glenn Campbell and also picked up a Best of Glenn Yarborough. So I think we got quite a lot of music still available to us.
Yeah, last night we made a list of the bands from the top 100 bands of the 70s whose style we thought we probably could find at least one of their songs we could do.
Yeah, so we're trying to expand. I mean, we didn't really necessarily think we'd be. So this is our 23rd show, and we will have learned, as of this show, 162 songs, and 10 repeats takes us to 172 songs, I believe, played. But at the rate we're going, we need another. That was mid-August to December. We're gonna need almost as many songs as we've played already. So we've been curating our giant master list and trying to make sure that we have new stuff and that we have plenty of songs so that we aren't just repeating stuff, which is challenging because we're now doing a lot of songs that while we may know them, we don't really know them.
We've never
tried to play them. For sure. So
yeah, there were two songs this week that, the one I thought I had heard. I know I heard, but I didn't really know how to sing it. I had listened to it over and over again to get the melody. And another one, I might have heard in the 70s or early 80s or whenever it came out, but totally forgotten about. And, okay.
Yeah, we had fun with this this set this week?
Got some new songs in here that are new to me songs that I really like that I had not really heard before or played before. One that somebody brought up at a ukulele jam, and I was like, I had never heard a song. Asked him, he's like, nah, I've never heard of it. And then we start getting, like, I think it was a request actually for this.
Yeah, somebody requested the song.
And it's like, well, I've heard it at least once at a ukulele jam where nobody knew how to sing it except the person who requested we play it.
Yeah, the good news is, though, when we eventually get back to life, which we will, the Hootenanny songbook is going to be about, we're already more than double. Our original Hootenanny songbook was 75 songs, and we've played all but, I believe, 16 of them at this point. And we'll be working our way through those. We had 16 songs, 20 plus weeks. And if we nick one song out of the Hootenanny songbook, that means, though, at some point we'll have to play Puff the Magic Dragon, though.
I know. I've requested it twice now, and you keep pushing it off.
Yeah, I do keep pushing it off. It's just so depressing.
No, it isn't.
It's terribly
depressing. We learned the final.
Yeah, there's a final verse, but it's...
Pugliaro added...
After everybody said, it's so depressing. So... that's on those Monster Mash. We're definitely going to do Adela. We'll definitely do Monster Mash.
That will be a seasonal song.
Yeah, we're saving a few songs for, you know, Halloween or more into October, since we're pretty sure we're not going to get out from under this pandemic before then. But
I was trying to think about
Christmas songs. What's that, Christmas? Yeah, I was thinking about Christmas. I was going to say, that's actually pretty nice. We'll have to figure out our schedule. We, like, for the week of Thanksgiving.
We leave on Wednesday,
so we may shift our show that week to Tuesday. Seth's with us, and I think Bruce and Nafali are on. So yeah, we'll do some seasonal music. If you have Christmas songs you like, or if you can think of Halloween themed songs for autumn,
yeah, Halloween theme
or something,
autumn songs. Any Christmas songs you think will sound okay on guitar? I mean, there are some classics that's like, we're not going to do
God Rest You Merry Gentlemen.
Probably not do Oh Holy Night.
Probably not. But I was thinking we could do Jingle Bell Rock. So
I thought, we're going to do one. We could do that one.
So y'all, if you're thinking about it, you have some thoughts for Christmas songs and seasonal songs for Thanksgiving.
And Hanukkah songs. We have one Hanukkah song we can do. Because it's on my Uke songbook.
Okay.
So anybody wants to request Hanukkah songs.
But we're going to definitely try and expand our repertoire with that. And we still got, we actually added the current, I think our current master list has over 350 songs or 363. So we have...
His reminder for fight practice.
Notification for fight practice, just like a salt in the wound. But yeah, so we definitely, if you have thoughts for some Christmas tunes, let us know, and we'll think of a few. Because I was looking at. I was looking at Burl Ives songs in general.
Oh yeah,
and he's got a few Christmassy tunes.
There's a couple songs of his I'd like to do.
Yeah, yeah. So, and I was actually thinking of a whistle tune that we might just do with whistle and uke, although I'm not sure how it'll sound, but it's not super hard to play, so it's not currently in the list. We spend a lot of time curating the list and editing songs.
And talking about music.
The plus of that is it distracts us from a lot of things. The minus of it is it distracts us from everything else. We have not successfully done much in the way of projects or much of anything.
And sometimes our practice, even though it's like we have 30 minutes of music, end up being an hour because we spend 20 minutes discussing how it reminds us of something. Or
we have to rearrange the song when we first get it together. Okay, well, I think it's about time to start. So tonight... We decided for a little change of pace, we are drinking Guinness from our Guinness draft glasses, and although we only had the 12-ounce bottles handy, that's like a half a Guinness.
Well.
But these are our nice set. We got a gold set for Mom. We bought a gold set for ourselves. We got a gold set for Prime Tours.
I think these are the ones from Prime Tours.
For Prime Tours. The nice, real, full Imperial pint glasses. All right. So, let's get this show on the road. And Barbara, I got your letter. You didn't have to write me a thank you note, but I'm glad that they worked, those pieces worked out for your display. They were actually pretty easy to make, and you'll laugh a little. I made them using the radial arm saw that Norm gave me when they came out to do the house thing, and I use that thing all the time. So, all right. Sounds like we're in tune. That song was Fields of Gold by Sting, 1993. What a great tune. I'd never heard it, and I'm a fan of his music, and I have quite a few of his albums. But apparently this one slipped by me. Great tune, though.
That one, I think, was one of the requests.
Yeah, I think maybe somebody requested it.
Because when they did, it's like, well, I've heard it once, but not by Sting. I heard it by a new band. It's much better by Sting than the new.
Well, almost anything is going to be better by Sting because of his voice and the fact that he has a full orchestra behind him playing the song. If we could get a full orchestra, like just off, like over there where they can't see, to bring in all the swell and the music, that'd be great. And now for something completely different. We've been wanting to do more songs by this particular group, so I suspect most of you will recognize this song. This is supposed to make it work. 1, 2, 3, 4. That was, of course, With a Little Help from My Friends by John Lennon and Paul McCartney, i.e. the Beatles, 1967. Easiest chords, but interestingly, every single time they do the refrain, it's in a different order. So you can't, it's not the easiest thing to memorize, but... I actually went through the Beatles songs, a lot of them, and we found about 10 songs by the Beatles that we think would be reasonably doable. So,
whenever you look at Beatles songs, they generally are hard, and I said, well, why don't we do some of their earlier songs? Because their earlier songs are easy, but not as easy as you think. They actually, when you actually look at their music, you can understand why they became famous, because they are... more complex than most music from the period.
Yeah, they just did a lot of stuff that was just light years ahead. I mean, you listen to some of these tunes, and like, there's things in this song that you weren't really hearing stylistically until the 70s, and there's bits and bobs that you could. This song could easily have slid into the 80s without too much hassle. So. But we're definitely going to do more Beatles songs, because I love the Beatles, and they wrote a lot of great tunes, so we're happy that we were able to do one. I tried to talk long enough for you to...
I'm almost there.
Uh-huh.
I'm closer.
Probably should just leave it on your instruments, that you're going to have to retune it when you untune it. the guitar channels I read online, they were talking about musical pet peeves, and these guys were talking about, you know, messy cables, and the one guy said, I hate it when musicians leave a snark tuner stuck on their guitar and they're out there playing for tens of thousands of people. It's totally unprofessional. All right, I suspect since we largely have a Skadian audience, I suspect you guys will know this song. For your non-Skadians, you might not. 1, 2, 3, 4. Queen of Argyll by the late, great Andy M. Stewart, 1983, written for the formation of what would become probably one of the great super bands in Irish music, Silly Wizard. talk about them every so often, and their music is still available and comprises some of the best sound songwriting musicians, and a lot of it was due to Andy M. Stewart's songwriting.
Yeah, a lot of it sounds like modernized traditional music, but actually it was original with him.
Yeah, Andy M. Stewart wrote a lot of great songs, and that's one of my favorites. Rick Smith and I have been playing that song for more than 30 years. All right, and now for something completely different. The more songs we do by this particular artist, the more I appreciate this particular artist. One, two. Wild World by Cat Stevens, 1970, from...
Teaser and the Firecat.
Teaser and the Firecat.
Or is it T for the Tillerman?
No, Teaser and the Firecat.
Oh,
right.
No, I think it's T for the Tillerman.
T for the Tillerman.
I always get those two confused. That picture, the picture on the cover, and I can remember.
Yeah, it's like somebody should have... Like, those albums should have all been books of some kind.
Well, and Numbers was. There was a coloring book with a short story in Numbers.
But with the art that's on T for the Tillerman and Teaser and the Firecat, it seems like Teaser and the Firecat, that sounds like that would be a kid's book. My appreciation for Cat Stevens grows every time we work on one of his songs. The guy writes great, great melodies, and as a great appreciation, his songs are actually recorded so that when you play them, you can play along with them. They're not in bizarro quarter tunings and things. For those of you musically inclined, we did a song last week, or a couple of weeks ago, where the recording, the CD recording, the recording off of iTunes was 0.37 semitones flat.
Compared to
what the chords we were playing was, you can't tune your guitar So I widgeted it with some software, but it was like, who the hell releases a song a third of a semitone off? So far, everything by Cat Stevens plays just like it. So I first heard this song when I was sitting in the trolley stop, which is a bar right near where we used to live in Dayton. And I was so stunned when I found out who the artist was. Maybe you will be too. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Somewhere in the distance.
the end together.
So believe it or not, that song is called Crow, and it's by Dan Fogelberg. 1975, from his album Captured Angel, on which he wrote all the songs and plays all the instruments and sings all the vocals. I had never even heard of this album. Most people think of Dan Fogelberg as kind of a balladeer. He wrote a lot of amazing songs. In fact, we did Longer earlier this year. This album is chock full of cool stuff, slide guitars. When we got to see him live, one of the best live shows I've ever seen, and in the middle of it, so he came out with his band and they played a lot of songs you'd recognize, and then his band stepped off stage, just three people, it was four piece, and he sat there for about 30 minutes playing slide blues guitar, reminiscent of a John Renborn style show where he just sang and played the blues for a bit, and then his band came back out, a piano player, drummer, and on that tour his bass player was Timothy V. Schmidt from the Eagles. So they did a bunch of Eagles songs, and at the time, the Eagles had not frozen over, and so that was about as close as you were going to get to seeing the Eagles, but they did quite a few songs that the Eagles did because Timothy Schmidt had written them. So that was super cool. I'm going to drink something before we sing this song. Spot on. We have one more song for you tonight. This is another song on my longtime learn list. And so, again, one feature of continuing to do this, and you folks keep showing up every week to listen to us, is that I'm actually working through a whole pile of songs that I've always wanted to learn. The question is, will I remember them? But at least we'll have good sheets and everything for them.
You ever wants to do the songs I always wanted to learn, you know. Ugly
Bugger
Paul and things like that.
You named one song.
Well, Autumn to May.
It's on the list. You haven't even suggested it.
Well,
it's on the list.
I suggested it once.
I don't remember. Thank you. That Is All For You by the band Sister Hazel. It was also written by somebody named Kay Block, and Sister Hazel wrote that song 1994, and it struck me, I was thinking, like, man, we're playing songs from the 90s, something relatively modern. Ah, yeah, it was 30 years ago. Because nothing in the last 10 years has been particularly oriented towards...
I could think we need to listen to some of the more recent country, because it's more...
More pop.
More pop-type music, but that would entail us to listen to...
I don't think we're going to be doing the works of P. Diddy or Kanye anytime soon, so... Not on acoustic guitars, anyways. So, as always... We hope that you are all safe and well, and we miss you all terribly, but we thank you for joining us for music, and we have quite a bit more music to do this year, so stick around, and if you think of songs again for some seasonal stuff for Thanksgiving-ish or Halloween or any of the holidays at Christmas, drop us a note or leave a comment.
And if there's other songs that or bands you can think of, just drop us a note.
Yeah, bands are good. We're starting to look at some other 70s groups like the Doobie Brothers and Michael McDonald and some of that. It's a good chance we might do Ride Like the Wind by Christopher Cross. So, anyways, we hope that you all take good care, and we'll see you next week.
Good night. Oh.
You could probably pull off Ed Sheeran. Yes, Melanie, we're actually going to look at him. Hey, good to see you, Duke Gabriel. Yes, we did a Blues Traveler song last week.